Hi, my name is Megan, and today we are going to be talking about demons, gods, legendary monkeys, and how the process of getting into college is garbage. Welcome to the epic crush of Genie Low. At 310 pages, The Epic Crush of Genie Low by F.C. Yee is a relatively quick read compared to some other YA works in the fantasy genre that are written using the philosophy of more is more. Maybe the authors are getting paid by the word, and if that's the case, then channel Dumas and get paid like you're writing The Count of Monte Cristo. So let's dive in. Genie Low is one of the many overachievers that can be found in the Bay Area. She has good grades and participates in any extracurricular that she can find, all in the hopes of winning a coveted spot in an Ivy League as far away from her home as possible. When she isn't studying or playing volleyball, she's trying to break the code on how to get into Harvard. But then again, so is everyone else. She's just one in a cutthroat crowd, even though her impressive height makes her quite literally stand head and shoulders above the rest. But everything changes when a mysterious boy claiming to be an exchange student from China enters the picture. Quentin Sun looks like he was pulled straight out of a K-drama, sending everyone in Genie's high school, including Genie herself, low and high key, swooning over him. But this exchange student isn't everything that he appears to be. When demons straight out of Chinese mythology start appearing and attacking Genie's town, Quentin reveals that he isn't a human boy, but the legendary Sun Wukong, the Monkey King from Journey to the West, right down to his ability to perform magic and in possession of a very real tail. Suddenly, getting into college is put on the back burner as Genie and Quentin are charged by heaven itself with ridding the Bay Area of Yaoguai, hellspawn that have been let loose from Diyu, Chinese hell. With the help of Quentin and Guanyin, the goddess of infinite mercy, Genie must tap into her own inner power that was once strong enough to level the very gates of heaven itself. But every minute she spends learning about her secret nature is time that the fate of the Bay Area and the plane of Earth remain in danger. I give The Epic Crush 4 stars, losing one for writing that tried too hard to be sarcastic and funny at times, but getting high marks for characters that have understandable struggles, despite the fact that they're fighting demons and have goddesses on speed dial. I liked that Genie approached her problems, whether they be academic or of cosmic origins, with a brutish ideology that had her saying, "People can always say I don't look impressive enough, but they can't argue over how strong I am once I punch them in the face." It's an in-your-face attitude that was about proving your strength even when you yourself think you aren't strong. And that's how it is sometimes. There are different ways of being strong, and for some it takes longer to figure out than for others. The most important thing is to never stop trying to figure out what that strength is, and to ultimately prove to yourself that you are made of the stuff that can storm the gates of heaven in your own way.